And the group of girls, who were you? The trendy one, the sporty, the, I don't know, the posh, the serious, the geek. Who are you?
The outsider.
The outsider.
Completely.
Why?
Yes. I don't know why. It was always very difficult for me to create that bond, that friendship. Maybe because besides school, I always had dancing lessons in the evenings and afternoons. I went to competitions and therefore did not go to school. Like, I was always playing at so many different concerts, mm-hmm. in a way that I did not really catch on. And so I was always the outsider, always mm-hmm. the really quiet one, just observing in a corner. Yeah, that was me. Mm-hmm.
On the go. With Ginta. Kaleen from Austria, thank you very much for being here today on the set of Elle on the Go with Ginta. We are here in Malmö, Sweden, and I want to know, what was the first thing that you put in your luggage when you packed for Sweden?
Wow, a good question. Thank you for having me, first of all. I think, let me remember that moment. I think the first thing I packed was definitely like some of my outfits that I got sent from my stylist, so just to make sure that all of them are in there. And I think the last thing was my toothbrush, because I still needed it in the morning. Yeah, but lots of suitcases, way too many.
Yeah, how many?
I think...
Loads.
4 big ones, and then 3 small ones, and then also carry-on things, and things that did not count as suitcase, you had to go to the special luggage section,
so wow.
Lots of things.
Amazing! Yeah. Where do you get your inspiration for fashion?
Oh, well, actually, in my private life, I'm not the most fashionable person. I'm more practical, so...
What do you wear?
Just gym clothes, basically.
Okay.
Really basic, like, things that I can move well mm-hmm. in. And now, here, I treat it like a fashion show, because why not? I feel like at Eurovision, you cannot be overdressed, so... Kaleen gets to go full out, so I have Stefan Orlich on board with me. He's my stylist, mm-hmm. and he, yeah, brings me all of those amazing pieces.
Wow, that's fabulous, Ellen, and I love this
piece. Oh, thank you very much.
It's a bit cold, but you mix and match well, so
exactly,
at least, you know,
yeah.
keep your feet warm,
yes.
and, you know, upper body is like sunshine, it's like...
Yeah, like a mermaid or something.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Thank you.
And so you don't choose your styles, or you choose your styles when you are on stage?
I do.
Yeah?
It's
just, do you participate in the process?
Yeah, it's a cooperation. I think that's the most important thing also, because I've worked behind the scenes so much. I know the process, and therefore that was one of the reasons why I became an artist. I wanted to make the decisions myself. I wanted to be the one to pick the color, to pick the outfit, just whatever it is. And so I'm very, very happy and grateful that I'm in the position right now. So it's all teamwork, and I have an amazing team, which I'm very grateful for.
Mm-hmm. Amazing. So talking about fashion and music, usually the trends follow each other.
Yeah.
They are on the same wave. How would you define your fashion and music style right now?
I feel like now, at the moment, it's time to try out things, to elaborate a little, and also just to have fun. I think that's what's most important at Eurovision, that, yeah, I already said you can never be overdressed. There is something for everyone, like different genres of music, different styles, and therefore, yeah, just go what you feel like in the moment and what feels authentic for you. Mm-hmm. I think that's the most important thing. And for me, tapping into the We Will Rave era of Kaleen just means, mm-hmm. yeah, go full out. Whether people like it or not, I actually don't really think about that. I just, if I like it, I'll wear it and just rock it.
Who's your favorite fashion designer or fashion inspiration?
Oh, wow. Well, at the moment, I do feel like, yeah, Beyonce still rules the world.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
she
whatever,
nails
whatever.
It.
Yeah, exactly.
Do you have any rituals before going on stage?
I feel like it's more focusing on myself, trying not to have too many people around. I'm not that hyping up before going on stage type of person. I really need silence and quiet and just comfort in the people I know who will be on stage with me, like my dancers now, mm-hmm. for example, and just really focus on, you know, you worked so hard to be here. Be proud of yourself. This is the moment you dreamed of. And then just enjoy the moment.
And how do you handle the pressure? Because there's a lot of responsibility on a stage like Eurovision.
That's true, but I have the feeling my biggest like threat to myself because I have so high expectations, and therefore I know I always try to give my best. I've worked very hard to be here. Life has prepared me for this very moment. So I'm like, well, you picked me, Austria picked me as an artist to represent our country. So I'll just do my best and then we'll just see what happens.
What was your first reaction when you found out that you will represent Austria, your country?
I couldn't like believe it. I was getting a phone call. It was the end of November and I did not expect the phone call at that time. And they were just telling me, well, you're going to Eurovision. I'm like, well, no, I can't believe this. Like, this cannot be happening. I'm sure you're still discussing. Like, can I already be happy? Or I don't believe it.
Was it on your list, like wish list? Or
yeah, it was like on top,
really?
Right on top. Yeah. And therefore I still haven't grasped it fully yet that like this is my performance that I'm doing here, that my dream is coming true. It's just so big that maybe, yeah, someday when I show the videos to my kids, I'll understand that this is actually, yeah, something that happened mm-hmm. and that I've worked for so hard.
Did you visualize, meditate? How did you attract things? How do you usually like?
Yeah, I try to do that, but also I sometimes find it difficult because when you get caught up in the, yeah, I'm sure it will happen, I'm sure it will happen, I'll just attract it, and then it doesn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
It's very, very devastating. And
yeah,
I've been there before.
Disappointing. Mm-hmm.
Last year, I also tried to, yeah, be the one going to Eurovision for Austria, and I got the message, well, you're out of the race.
Mm-hmm.
And I really tried to visualize. Like, I already practiced giving interviews about how it
yes.
is going to Eurovision. And then I got this slap in the face, and I was very, very, very sad. And therefore, this year, I took it more easily, and
mm-hmm.
I did not tap into that fully. I just worked hard, and it worked this year, and I'm just very, very grateful for that.
Yeah, you just let it go, and then it just happened, right?
Yeah,
magic
maybe
happens.
That's always, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What does music mean for you?
It means a lot to me. I grew up with music, with all different genres. My dad was a music producer, a composer, my
wow.
grandma as well. So we had a recording studio on the first floor of the
Your
house
grandma
I grew
as well.
Up in. Yeah.
That's
it runs in the family. Yeah. Like very different genres than I
mm-hmm.
do at the moment. But yeah, I think as a kid, I fell asleep listening to music. And therefore, I could not imagine how my life would be without music. I'm a singer, I'm a dancer. Stage is where I feel most myself. And therefore, life without music, I don't know what that'd be.
But so at home, do you ever play together? Do you listen to the music together? Do you have like interaction around it with your family?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, like, of course, now I moved away. I moved to Vienna and they're
mm-hmm.
from Upper Austria. So unfortunately, especially now in this very intensive time, I don't see them as much. But yeah, I think like Christmas comes up in my mind, for example. We
yes.
sing about
mm-hmm.
half an hour Christmas songs
mm-hmm.
every year, and I love that tradition.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it's definitely really, really important for everyone still.
And when you're in the studio, do you compose? Do you participate actively in the process, or you prefer to interpret the songs that maybe other authors write?
Well, I had a lot of time in my life where I just did covers and like, yeah, interpreted other songs.
Mm-hmm.
But then I thought, okay, if I want to be on stage as an artist myself with my own songs, I have to have my own music. So
mm-hmm.
how do you get that? Yeah,
yeah,
you have to learn to write songs. And so I did. It was not easy, I have to say, because I don't play any instruments.
Mm-hmm.
But I learned my way into it, and yeah, now I do write songs completely on my own. I also participate in the process, so
mm-hmm.
a bit of everything, and yeah, it's always fun and magical.
And what does the process look like? Do the words come first, or music come first, or the beats?
It can happen, any, like, everything can
no
happen.
Rules.
No,
no
rules. No rules. Reminds me of Eurovision. For me, I think I do always write words down
mm-hmm.
in my notebook somewhere, so that's always there. But when I really sit down and I feel like, yeah, I want to write a song,
mm-hmm.
usually music is what comes first. Or just the idea of, okay,
mm-hmm.
today we do up-tempo, today we do a ballad. And then I look at the notebook and I see like, okay, what feels right from all of my notes.
Mm-hmm. Going back to your teenage years, did you have an item, an accessory that was really essential for you?
Wow, not really. I think for me it was always more this feeling of having my family around
mm-hmm.
that made, yeah, just every day so much better. And I remember I was traveling a lot with my sisters and my mom because we did a lot of dancing and singing competitions.
Mm-hmm.
So we were always traveling together, and therefore It was not like what was in the suitcase. It was more like, yeah, are we all together?
It was that feeling, always, right?
Yeah, exactly. Feeling of home is just everywhere where my mom and my sisters are. That's,
do they still come to support you when you...
They will come today. Yes.
They will come
today? They arrive today, yeah.
Oh,
so
nice.
I'm really, really looking forward to seeing them. Also that they get to experience this whole thing mm-hmm. with me. I think it's very, very special, yeah.
Oh, fabulous. It's so nice to have such a deep bond with the family.
It is, yeah. I'm very grateful for that.
How many times do you talk on the phone per day?
Oh, well, yeah, per day. Usually once per day. Mm-hmm. But yeah, at this time now, the last couple of months, it was very, very intense. So I did not manage to as much, but yeah, twice a week still.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Have you ever tried the digital detox?
No, like not consciously, but I'm very careful, like, with how much time do I spend on my phone. Mm-hmm. And I really consciously try to put it away, mm-hmm. not be on the phone. Like having dinner, the phone doesn't have to be on the table. It can be in the bag.
Oh my gosh, I couldn't agree more. Mm-hmm. You know, in Switzerland, there's even a game where
yeah.
everybody, when we gather for a dinner, we put the phone in a pile in the
yeah.
middle of the table.
Oh,
the
so
first one that picks the phone pays for the dinner.
That's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I
want
to do that. Yeah, I'll take that with me.
That's
very
fab.
Good.
If you could choose an artist to collaborate with, who would that be?
Again, Beyoncé, probably.
Beyoncé.
Yeah, she definitely shaped me as a person, and I love her professionalism, her work, her mm-hmm. everything, basically. She's, like she says, that she's the first one who's arriving on set, mm-hmm. and she's the last one going home,
mm-hmm.
and I'm the same. So I feel like, yeah, I could work very well together, and she's just, yeah, the best for me.
Oh, that's great. Well, she's a complete artist.
Yeah.
As you are.
Thank you.
And when you were a little girl, in the group of girls,
yes.
who were you? The trendy one, the sporty, the, I don't know, the posh, the serious, the geek. Who are you?
The outsider.
The outsider?
Completely.
Why?
Yes. I don't know why. It was always very difficult for me to create that bond, that friendship. Maybe because besides school, I always had dancing lessons in the evenings and afternoons. I went to competitions and therefore did not go to school. Like, I was always playing at so many different concerts mm-hmm. in a way that I did not really catch on. And so I was always the outsider, always mm-hmm. the really quiet one, just observing in a corner. Yeah, that was me.
Mm-hmm. And your beauty routine, what do you do in the morning?
Well, at the moment, the first thing I do is brushing my teeth,
okay.
of course. Yeah, showering, and then I have this gua sha.
Oh, gua sha.
Yeah.
Oh, I love gua sha.
Yeah.
It really
that.
Helps.
Yeah.
Like the circulation.
Yeah.
And how do you find it? Do you use
really
it since a long time?
No, I actually started using it, I think, yeah, beginning of this year. So mm-hmm. part of the Eurovision process as well. Yeah, and also steaming my voice. That's what I also do every day.
Mm-hmm. Is there a part of your body that you prefer, that you love? What's your favorite part of your body?
Oh, I love that question. I actually love my collarbones.
Okay, collarbones.
Yeah.
Wow, they're beautiful.
They're
very, like, so they're very present today.
Yes, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you. Show what you feel comfortable with. And for me, that's a sign of just self-confidence.
Mm-hmm. Were you always self-confident, or have you ever felt comfortable in your own skin, or you had doubts maybe as a teenager?
Definitely.
How
I think
did that go?
Every one of us goes through that journey, and still I have actually very acne-prone skin,
mm-hmm.
and therefore that's, I think, like, that's my biggest insecurity.
Mm-hmm.
But also here I feel like I have two different personalities. One is the stage personality,
mm-hmm.
and the other is the private one.
Mm-hmm.
The private one definitely is not as confident. She does not, yeah, wear short things or, yeah, just dare to go on a stage like
mm-hmm.
that. And the stage personality just rolls with it.
Wow.
Yeah,
so
it's crazy.
How do you switch these personalities? You just take away, like, put away the costume, the stage costume, and then you just switch, or?
Maybe it's that. I actually don't know. Like, my mom kept telling me from, like, way back then that I have two personalities, and
okay.
I don't know what the switch is. Maybe it's cameras,
uh-huh.
or maybe it's a stage.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I have to find out. But it's good that now, like, that I'm older, more mature, and all of that, the stage person, like, the private person gets to take a little from the stage person as well,
mm-hmm.
and gets more confidence and feels, like, more secure in her own opinion. I think that's
mm-hmm.
really important.
Well, it comes with time, maybe.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, with maturity and with experience.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
So now let's play a little game.
Yes.
A little personality game. To find out a bit more about yourself. So just pick one.
Okay.
Dinner out or dinner at home?
Dinner at home. I'm a stay-at-home person.
Yes, do you cook?
Yeah, I cook every day.
Really?
I cook, yeah, I love that. And that's what I miss here, actually, a bit. But just the food you're used to. I'm a very habit person. Mm-hmm. So also there's not much, like, difference in the things I cook. I eat the same thing for breakfast every single day.
What do you eat for breakfast?
It's a cereal bowl, basically, mm-hmm. with kiwi and some fruit in it. Mm-hmm. And then oats and stuff like that. Yeah, some... Yeah, definitely dinner at home.
So more of healthy options?
Yeah, yeah, no? Yeah, that's me.
Rather than comfort food.
Yeah, although that's also needed at some points.
Sometimes.
Yeah, definitely.
We need to break a little bit the rules.
Yes.
Why not? Maximal or minimal?
Now I'd say maximal. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just because I'm in that era of life at the moment, I feel like.
And even off stage?
I feel like I can dare to do more of that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. I should do more of that.
Mm. What about coffee or tea?
Tea, definitely. I don't drink coffee.
You don't drink coffee?
Yeah, no, okay. I've never started
Which
it.
Which tea? What kind of tea?
Actually, I prefer hot water and lemon mm-hmm. juice, mm-hmm. very fresh, or ginger tea or something like that. So very, yeah, or herbs, mm-hmm. very just subtle with the stomach and all of that. Mm-hmm.
Healthy options.
Very simple. Yes, healthy options again.
What about cell phone or book?
Well, at the moment, unfortunately, it is cell phone because you try to update everyone about mm-hmm. everything. But yeah, I also love the book.
Do you read?
Often? Too little. Mm-hmm. I love to read more, but at the moment, I don't have the time to actually find the books that I'm interested in. I feel mm-hmm. like it depends on the book. If I really can stick with it or not.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes the book chooses you, maybe.
Yeah, maybe I should take my time, go to a bookstore and just see what happens, mm-hmm. yeah.
Are you more of a day person or night person?
Day person, I'd say.
Day person.
Yeah, I'm also, usually, like if there's not much happening, I'm going to bed like at 10, around 10. It's mm-hmm. not too early, but also not too late. And I'm not the going out type of person, so it's definitely day.
Mm-hmm. I can relate. And what about sex, day or night?
Both.
Both.
Both, yes.
Why not? Shower or bath?
Shower. Shower, yeah. I do have a bath at home, but I think I use it twice a year. Mm-hmm. Like, not too much, because I feel like it always... like, you can only do it before you go to bed, because otherwise I would just be, like, dead afterwards. Mm-hmm. You could do nothing with me anymore,
yeah.
So... I'm a shower person.
Yeah, the shower energizes you, that's for
yeah.
sure.
Mm.
Cat or dog?
Dog person.
Dog?
I'm a dog
person.
Do you have a dog? Unfortunately, not anymore, no. But I grew up with dogs, so I really, really love them. And now I'm just waiting for the right time to get one mm-hmm. again. But I love them.
Mm-hmm. They're very social. I
yeah.
love dogs too as well.
Yeah.
Sea or mountain?
I'm from Austria, so I should pick mountain, but I actually...
Love
the sea, yes.
Yeah, you're dressed like a mermaid
yeah, today.
So,
yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, no, definitely sea. I always love going on a vacation to the seaside, mm-hmm. like watching a sunset or a sunrise mm-hmm. right into the ocean. It's beautiful.
What's your favorite spot for vacation, like for the sea?
Islands. Yeah, islands. I do love islands. Like somewhere, yeah, at the beach. I love going to Greece every year. Like mm-hmm. we pick a different island every year. And so I'm excited to see what island it will be this mm-hmm. year.
The Mediterranean vibe.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm-hmm. Cinema or Netflix?
Cinema, because I love popcorn.
Okay, yes. You love popcorn?
I always get the biggest
Oh my gosh, I feel you. I can relate totally. Like,
yeah.
you get the big one?
I get the big one
okay.
and I don't share.
And you just dive into it.
Exactly, yeah. And I also take it at home. Like, sometimes I go to the cinema just to get popcorn. Take it home with me.
Oh my gosh, I gotta do that. I have to try.
Yeah, do that.
We did ask some of your supporters,
yes.
your fans, to make a couple questions.
All
so
right.
just pick one. They may be nasty, they may be nice. I don't
good.
Know. Just
okay.
pick.
I'll pick the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's a long one. How do you stimulate your creativity? Are you fully aware and lucid, or let yourself go in blurry lines when you create? That's a good question.
Mm.
I feel like it depends on the time, because sometimes you cannot really Like, you don't have an option. You just have to be creative because there's a deadline or something.
Yes.
So then you have to just trust the process and mm-hmm. also trust that with a deadline, something mm-hmm. good can happen. But also, it's always nice to just, see what happens without a deadline, without mm-hmm. any plan. Although I'm having a hard time because I love to plan and I love to control. So, yeah.
How does it relate to your creativity?
That was the first part of the question, actually. Mm-hmm. I love getting inspired by watching documentaries of other artists.
Okay.
Like,
who's your favorite?
Well, I watched this recently of Ed Sheeran. Mm-hmm. Just backstage at the tour, like, how does he write songs? Mm-hmm. All of that, of course, then Beyoncé, I've already said so. But basically every single artist that's out there who just has a camera following them, I think mm-hmm. it's so interesting to see all of the behind the scenes that maybe social media is not showing. But
Definitely.
It's also such a big part of the process. Yeah. So, and then I always feel like, he did it. He's just a person or she's just a person. So why should I not try it as mm-hmm. well?
Yeah, it gives you like a lot of motivation.
It's very empowering, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I totally agree with you.
Yeah, so that's in there.
And the last question, if you were not a musician, not an artist, who would you be?
It's such a tough question. Well, I don't know if it counts, like, to be a dancer, but because I'm a dancer and
a
singer, like,
it's... Okay, any artistic?
Well, something creative for sure. Maybe, a designer, like clothes designer, or mm-hmm. architect, or something. Yeah, someone creating something. Yeah.
Well... Maybe the next life?
maybe the next life. Yeah.
Thank you so much for being with us today. On the go. On the go. With Ginta.